Hey everybody and welcome to this week's video where I want to show you how I turned the sound of popping popcorn in a pan into some metal type dystopian beat. Many years ago I was reading some YouTube comment on a drum solo by the Slipknot drummer Joey Jordison. Saying that it sounds like somebody's making popcorn in the background. So I had this idea to try what actually happens if I use a popcorn sample and try to turn this into a metal type beat. I think you can apply this concept to almost any type of random recording of sounds with some transients. So it shouldn't be wind or water, but let's say you're just washing the dishes in the kitchen, those sounds would be perfect for it as well, because they have some clear attacks and transients. And before I'm going to start, just one little reminder that in case you like the video, be welcome to subscribe to my channel. I'll post a new video on every Monday, either like a tutorial or performance video. And I think now we're good to go to head over to Ableton and start this thing. So the first thing I tried is kind of like always using the standard sample. In this case, I can play it once more for you. It was, just a second, this one. And as I mentioned, it's really transient heavy, so you can get lots of pops and cracks out of it, which is what I wanted. And then what I always like to do, in case you watched some of my other videos, I like the combination of the arpeggiator and the sampler. So I load it into the sampler, pick the slice option, just program basically one note. I often do it just randomly, it doesn't matter which one. And use the steps function so it really starts moving around through those slices, and play a bit with distance and pick a rate and a style. And then usually some interesting motif comes up, and in this case it sounded like this before I processed it further. Oh. Sounds like either some train or some footsteps, but definitely interesting. And also it's not a clear rhythm, but at the same time there's some sort of groove to it, something I actually really like. And then I tried to tweak it a little. So in this case, the drum bass helped me to bring a bit the bottom to the front. It's again very soft because I had to tame it down due to the saturator that is going to follow. I'm gonna put this on already. So now it really becomes intense and heavy. Actually, oh yeah, I low passed it a little. Because initially I wanted this to be my kick drum, but then figured out it sounds more like some, I mean, it doesn't sound like a guitar, but since I was thinking a bit of metal, I kind of thought of some downstrokes or dead notes that could be played like this. So I imagined it as some type of dead note, riff, loop kind of thing. And in the end, I just wanted it to make a bit wider. And there's this kind of weird loop, call it however. I just called it loop, not very creative. But it's already a great starting point and I liked it a lot, but I wanted to have some more drum sounds. So let's check the next one. This is snare. And again, I used the slice function to find a place that I liked. Which is somewhere here, all right. Just one hit. Try to give it even more transient through the compressor. not on 100%, which is important. Like it could still be a bit lower, but it always depends on what you want. I want it to be really punchy. And then actually what I also did in the past, make it sound more lo-fi and distorted with the redux function. But I actually really like it. And as you can see, actually, I haven't mentioned it. I transpose it down quite a lot because otherwise it was sounding too high, which is also nice. It sounds uglier in some way. Also with the loop. Oh, now I've freezed it. Okay, now, yeah. But it's also transposed down. I often, especially if I want to find some kick drum sounds, I would transpose it down by quite some notes and steps. And together with the loop, I mean, I told you this thing about the guitar, but it could actually at the same time be some lo-fi garage tom rhythm as well, however you want to call it. I mean, this is abstract anyway, but I like this already. And let's see what other sounds we have. So this one I called trap question mark, and I'm really not familiar with the world of trap music, just know a couple of things. But there's something about this 32nd note, 16th note hi-hat blasts that always appear, and somehow I ended up creating something that sounded like some of those hi-hat figures in a kind of poor way, but it fits the feel. And there's actually no processing. I just transposed it up, so it sounds more like some type of hi-hat thing. Let's see how it sounds. Yeah, that's kind of it with the rest. And yeah, it has some industrial but also metal feel again. And yeah, it's this kind of poor trap rhythm that somehow fits to the rest, in my opinion. And so now the kick is missing. So for the kick, I really tried to have some very busy 16th, is it actually? No, it's actually on 32nd note grid. So really fast bursts of three notes together on 32nd note basis that by itself, without any processing, sounded like this. Which almost sounds like some warped, slowed down, although it's really fast, but it reminds you of the sound that happens when you warp something and lower the tempo. And again, I used the drum bass to get some of the bass out of it, which made a huge difference. I like this effect actually a lot for drums. Also, how you can tame the transients and make the signal tighter. It's really nice. Some EQ curve to bring out the bass even more. Almost resonating there, but yeah, I kind of liked it. And again, compressor for the kick, although here you really don't hear it that much. But yeah, it glues it more together and lowers those resonances or bassy peaks a little. I'll leave it here for now. And there we have our drum group. Again, those combinations of single elements also sound really interesting, like this, for example, or yeah, you get the idea. I'll leave it together now. So we have our drum group. I routed it together to bus one and put this glue compressor onto it, which I actually put on some really radical setting. But I like that you can tell him some range so it doesn't, although the settings are really hard and the threshold is really low, he just goes until a certain point. And using this as some parallel compression was gluing this whole thing together in a way I really liked. Don't know how this translates through YouTube, but here it definitely has some positive effect without drastically changing the sound. It just sounds punchier and better, in my opinion. Of course, this is always really subjective. So the next thing I did was recording the loop again, so this one, and I recorded it onto a new track, which landed here. And I just wanted to have some more, I called it guitar, of course it's not a guitar, but I wanted to have some more distorted, dystopian ambience around this groove. And I pitched it up by 24 half notes, so it became 2 octaves higher and sounds like this. Like some annoying group of insects that is swirling around you. And actually, I have to admit here, I was using third-party plugins. One is Primal Tap from Sound Toys, which I love for distortion purposes. I use it more for distortion than actually as a delay. And here you can see the settings. It's really charismatic, and I don't know anything else, at least from things that I have, that create the same way. And I enhance it a bit with Devil Lock, which I also love because nothing destroys audio so much like this thing. And it's always worth putting this onto something that is supposed to sound really aggressive. And I adjusted the EQ curve for this one so it doesn't overwhelm the whole sound. And they are still on bypass because if I speak and activate this, it's already too much for my computer and the screen recording and the low latency. So I'll just quickly activate them, freeze it, and play it for you. So the whole thing sounds like this. It creates some glitches, but I somehow don't really mind because it sounds very industrial and ugly anyway. And sometimes I even like if those glitches appear and I don't bother editing them out. Of course, you could also say I'm lazy, but in this way, I really don't mind. And then I again bounced it to this track. So this is exactly the same. Git 2 is like Git 1, but just bounced with the plugins already. And then here, I again loaded it into a simpler. So I could actually find some pitch that I like. Again, limit the frequency band a little bit. And it then sounded like this. I'm going to freeze it again. And I panned it right, so I thought this original signal I could have on the left side. And I made some aux channel with the redux to just destroy this even more. And although Git 1 is the same, oh Jesus Christ, I'm clipping a little. Git 1 is the same, but if I put this in the middle, it actually sounds even better. I guess you could do the same by some editing with those, but sometimes doubling voices just does some trick. Yeah, sure, it's also just louder, but it's some nice ambience, really ugly, but in some positive way. And if you put it together with the beat, I'm actually quite happy with it. Again, some interesting combinations happen if you don't use the whole beat. Like, for instance, just this. You get the idea. And what actually also feels nice, if we bring back the original sample, because, is this, oh, sorry. Because it gives some organic ambience that sounds totally off rhythmically, but at the same time interesting. Just listen to this. And yeah, that's how I turned this popcorn sound into some, I wouldn't call it exactly metal, but some metal type, bizarre, dystopian beat with some poor trap element to it. And I hope you enjoy this and it inspires you a little to experience this by yourself. So thanks again for being with me up until this point. I hope it inspired you and you feel excited to start some beat making with this approach, with some recordings you make somewhere around your house or outside, wherever. I think it's really important to not have too high expectations when doing it, because it can always lead to nowhere, or sometimes it needs 20 minutes until you find rhythms or sounds that inspire you enough to create something more out of it. But it's definitely worth trying. You shouldn't give up after 3 minutes. Once again, the little reminder that in case you liked this video, I'm happy about any new subscriber to my channel. And apart from that, I think I can wish you finally a good week and inspiration with whatever you create. And I hope to see you next time. Bye.